The following presentation by Chestnut Hill Conservancy is part of our History at Home collection of activities from our archives. Community stories from our past in the comfort of your home. History at Home is made possible by our generous members and supporters. So thank you. This illustrated lecture, entitled Four Local Businesses, was originally created as a captioned slideshow for the October 2019 Night of Lights exhibition along Germantown Avenue. Four Local Businesses was developed by Elizabeth Jarvis and produced by Leah Silverstein and Molly Murphy, with narration by George McNeely. Chestnut Hill celebrates four businesses that have served Chestnut Hillers for generations and have become a familiar presence on Germantown Avenue. Killian Hardware, in Chestnut Hill for 107 years. William Killian and his wife, Minnie Gowdy Killian, opened Killian Hardware in 1913. They had no children, so the store went to her brother, Russell Gowdy. Their first store was at 8611 Germantown Avenue, and in 1923 moved to where the Philadelphia Print Shop is today. This is Russell Gowdy, the first of several Russell Gowdys, in a Killian Hardware delivery vehicle in the 1920s. The building with the awning is now Robertson's Flowers. Donat's Hotel was located at 8450 Germantown Avenue. Prohibition put it out of business, and it was torn down in 1925, becoming the current site of Killian Hardware. The first Russell Gowdy built this fence for a shop window display. The grocery store that was later to house Robertson's is visible in the reflection. Lampshades are displayed in the 1930s. Russell's brother was John Nelson Gowdy, who was the father of the second Russell Gowdy, who was born in 1930 and worked in the store until 2014. Andirons to teapots to figurines were sold at Killian's in the 1930s. Tools were displayed in the Highland Avenue window in the 1930s. Killian's in 1971 looked as it does today, except that Belgian block covered all of Germantown Avenue, not just near the curbs. The second Russell Gowdy, who was born in 1930, reports he would sell one vacuum cleaner a day back in the 1970s. Russell Gowdy, on the right, showed mittens made by his wife, Rebecca, to customers in 1981. He worked at the store from 1943 to 2014. The store is run today by his son, the third Russell Gowdy, who was born in 1961. From McNally's Light Lunch to McNally's Tavern, beginning in 1921, Hugh McNally, born in 1878, was a Philadelphia rapid transit trolley driver. His wife, Rose O'Brien, observed that PRT workers needed a lunchroom in Chestnut Hill. Seen here are Rose and Hugh, and from the left, their sons, Hugh Patrick, Arthur, and John, about 1908. In 1921, the McNallys got permission to open McNally's Light Lunch, on PRT property by the trolley tracks, across from where McNally's Tavern is today. Rose and Hugh's success afforded them the ability to have their growing sons' portraits taken again around 1915. McNally's in the 1920s was one of the few restaurants in Chestnut Hill that served African Americans. Pictured are Rose and Hugh's sons, John on the left and Hugh Patrick, around 1923. This search warrant from 1929 certified that McNally's was not serving liquor, although one nickel slot machine was seized. from 1919 to 1933, prohibition was in effect, so only barges, better beverages, and the like were served. Andy McRae was the father of Sarah McRae, who married Hugh Patrick McNally. Andy owned the houses, seen second and third from the right, on East Evergreen Avenue, just west of Prospect Avenue. Peggy Lawless, who married Hugh James McNally, who was born in 1932, grew up in the house on the left, through the clearing. In 1927, the McNallys bought the newly built building at 8634 Germantown Avenue and moved their business there. In 1934, it became a tavern after Prohibition was lifted. Hugh Patrick McNally stands at the back door of McNally's around 1930. On the right is Hugh Patrick McNally in front of the Art Deco-style Gulf Station around 1938 across from McNally's. The Gulf Station at Germantown Avenue and Bethlehem Pike was a regional training center for service attendants. Hugh Patrick McNally is seen here on the right with John O'Barra, working the bar around 1953. The third generation, Hugh James McNally, took over after returning from service in Korea and stayed for the rest of his life. He is seen here greeting holiday carolers around 1980. Seen here in the 1960s, McNally's did not need a big sign to sustain its popularity. No women were admitted until 1960. Murray's Optician opened next door in 1961. In 1988, Ann McNally founded the Run for the Hill of It to raise funds for children with serious medical problems. Runners gathered at Bells Mill Road and Forbidden Drive for the start of the race in 1990. Sisters Anne, pictured, and Meg McNally are the fourth generation to run McNally's Tavern and now have a concession stand at Lincoln Financial Field, serving their famous Schmitter sandwich. Anne is seen here with Rich Carbonara. Robertson's Flowers, five generations in business, adapting to change. In 1927, George Robertson, who had been a gardener on a private Chestnut Hill estate, set up a landscaping business with his son, Charles, at 8339 Germantown Avenue, where they had an office and storage. Jenny and George Robertson posed for their portrait in the 1930s. Their daughter, 18-year-old Janet Robertson, later Red House, started selling flowers out of a bucket in front of this building, presently Fiesta Pizza. The flower business grew from there, pictured here between 1945 and 1950. The Robertson's six children are from the left: Dick, Charles, Malcolm, Janet, Marion, and Bud, seen around 1915. Charles, Janet, Marion, and Bud were all involved in the Robertson family flower business. In 1952, the business moved to 8501 Germantown Avenue, formerly the Johnson Market, seen here around 1900. This rear view of the building was taken right before it was renovated in 1952, along East Highland Avenue. The building was renovated with paneling in the main room and a large fireplace on the back wall. Here, Bud Robertson presides over the grand opening in 1952. Behind that wall were five cubicles for people to work at desks and take phone orders for flowers, as 80% of the business was conducted by phone orders. In the white dress is Marion Robertson Redhouse. The Robertsons built this greenhouse lean-to as a much-needed prep area in 1956, as their business continued to expand. Shown here is the greenhouse lean-to and the growing fleet of delivery vehicles. Pictured here around 1965 are Robertson family members, sitting in front of Robertson's flowers and events at the bench dedicated to Bud Robertson. From the left are Bud's sister, Janet Robertson Redhouse, Bud's daughter, Joy Rotel, Bud's brother, Charles Robertson, Bud's sister, Marion Robertson Redhouse, Bud's wife, Marion Robertson, and Bud's son, Bruce Robertson. Janet Robertson Redhouse and Marion Robertson Redhouse, sisters, married Redhouse brothers. The Sylvia Dress Shop, owned by Sylvia Musselman, is seen here around 1977, next to Robertson's flowers. In 1985, Robertson's added a conservatory in the back to sell houseplants, with the glass and wood parts shipped in two containers from England. Philippi Brothers of Chestnut Hill erected the steel framing. As supermarkets and big box stores began to sell houseplants, Robertson's rented the conservatory to the restaurant, Cake. The Chestnut Hill Cheese Shop, with roots in a Germantown grocery. Joseph Weiss, at the age of 59, opened the Chestnut Hill Cheese Shop in 1963, after previously owning the Washington Lane Market in Germantown since 1927. Joel Weiss was still serving customers in the 1970s. Working at the cheese shop was a family affair. From the left is Abe Kaufman, Joe Weiss's brother-in-law, Abe's wife Gertrude Weiss Kaufman, Joe Weiss, and Dick Brown. All three of Joe's children, Eileen, Dan, and David, worked in the store over the years, as well as his wife Marie, who assisted during the holidays and special events. In 1967, the shop's French Cheese Festival was held. Pictured here from the right are Eileen Weiss Merlin, her mother Marie Weiss, and an employee, Brian Beal. Dan Weiss, seen here in 1988, began working at the shop in 1965 when he was a senior in high school, and later worked while home from the University of Nebraska. He began working there full-time in the spring of 1971. Dan Weiss took over the shop in 1978. Dan's wife Susan and his daughters Jacqueline and Gabrielle were also involved in the business.